the stuff I praise. Because I praise brings the presence of God into the situation. Psalm 24 says, lift up your head to be gained to thee, lift up the everlasting doors, and the King of glory will come in. So he tries to stop the King of glory from coming in. He tries to stop the King of glory from entering into our situations. But I dare to throw your head back. I forget about your problems and release your prayer into this great God. Release your praise to this mighty God. Release your praise to this awesome God. Release your praise to this righteous God. Come on, saints. Open your mouth to the King of glory and come in. Open your mouth and give your praise. Welcome in this place. Welcome in your families. Welcome in your children. Welcome in your job. Open your mouth. He is great. Greatly to be praised. So this bridge just says, great are you, Lord. We're going to declare over our situations this morning. We're going to declare the greatness of our situations this morning, God. Thank you.
Yeah.
should serve Him with all your strength and with all your might. God bless you. You may be seated. Thank you. Thank you. I don't know about you, but I'm enjoying myself in the presence of the Lord. Amen. It's so good to be in Blue Hill Road. My Blue Hill Road. Amen. And I say that for more than one reason, really. Because some of you didn't even know when we had a Jesse Cloud Board Church here. As a matter of fact, not a cloud board church, when we just had a tent. So I'm not here to give you a history of where this church comes from. But I can tell you that I see Denver in the Darndale. You're still here. Who could remember the tent? Amen. On a Sunday evening. But look what God has done. Look where God has brought you. Amen. I respect our lead pastor, Pastor Tim, and his wonderful, beautiful wife. Amen. My wife reminded me when I was coming up, he said, you know something? Both of them was your sisters, Pastor, you know. So in other words, look what God has done. Amen. God has placed me to come back. Amen. To hear what they're doing, or to see what they're doing, and whatnot. So, Pastor Randy and his beautiful wife, Sister Levine. Oh my God, they're so great, wonderful. Give them a hand. I just, as a matter of fact, when Pastor Randy opened his opening statement, I said, well, I could almost close out, just come up and say the benediction. Because he actually said everything what I had on my paper. So, therefore, I won't have to preach too hard. And I don't have to preach long. Because Sister Beth, nobody remembers what you preached at home. Amen. All they say is what the pastor preached long. Amen. But I'm learning now. As I get older, it's the fullness of examples that our elders leave with us. And that is leave you in a spot where you want more. Yeah, don't preach too long. Because, like I said, they don't remember nothing. When you get around the table, people say, well, what did the pastor preach? All he do is preach good. But they remember that people. Well, I don't have time for that. That is to remember that. But it's so good to see many of the faces that if I hadn't come here today, I wouldn't have seen you.
Wouldn't do much of
for years. But it's so good to look from this spot, from my vantage point, and to see across this whole congregation, I can see people that I could look back way many, many, many years ago. Amen. While some of you, I guess, take advantage and come to Bluebird Road, which is a good spot. Yeah, hot spot. And the thing about that is that I don't know what you could tell your pastor when you go back.
Yeah,
we say, tell him must come too. Today, Blue Hill Road paused to celebrate family. Family. I want everybody, under the sound of my voice, to please love your family. Good to see you, Lord. Good to see you. Good to be here. The woman I pointed out to you a while ago She lived with me for 55 years. I have license for her for 55 years. You understand what I'm saying? And I told you, I think it was yesterday, some of you were there, I told you, don't come to me with nothing else. I ain't see nothing else. Only one Wayne. And I trust God that if what side it go, whatever it go, do for God's sake. If I go, God don't keep her long to suffer. And if I go, don't keep me long. Because I want you to know, that's my love, man. And I ain't looking for nothing else. Hello. Amen. So, thank you very much. Now, they didn't invite me. Pastor Tim and them didn't invite me. Okay, I tell them I'm coming. Okay. It just happened so that it fallen. It happened so that this fall into my grip, my calendar. Amen. But he gave me a theme. And that theme is the family. A reflection of God's love in the earth. If I was in another place, we would have been getting ready to come out. But since I'm in my Blue Hill Road, right. Amen. So I'm going to say a little something. So that all of us could be benefited. That's all right?
Yes.
Amen. Today we have come to celebrate and to focus on the family. All of us were born into a family. Remember, this was God's idea. You may not like the family you are in, but you have nothing to do with it. And I sometimes look at people and some children, and I always tell them, learn to appreciate where God put you. And stop looking at what you see, what you think you see in other people's family. Hello? Sometimes we look at other family and wish that we were in that family. But every family has its problems. The grass always looks greener on the other side. Amen? If somebody could put Deuteronomy 6:4-9, for me on the board so everybody could read it. Deuteronomy 6:4-9. But until it get there, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one.
6:4-9.
You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength. And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house. When you walk, by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up, you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them on the doorposts of your heart and in your gates. And this is a God word. When we love God, see, and I want to establish something here. We as children of God, we as families, we sometimes forget the source of who's supposed to keep us together. The source of us living together as a family is God. When we love God, our family will reflect God. Hello. Appositive, I looked at that word in doing a little search. He said reflection means a light.